What do I say when, how do you handle when people call you back? Are you kidding me? You answer the phone and say, hey, they're like, hey, you called me. Say, yeah, I was making calls earlier. How you doing today? I'm a local real estate agent. Something I can do to help you? What's up, everybody? Ricky Carruth here. Welcome back to another live cold calling session. And I have my man, okay, the man, the myth, the legend. He's wearing jersey number 34. He's coming out of Mr. Chris Newton. How you doing, buddy?
No pictures, no autographs.
That was actually Chris Newton for you guys who didn't catch that. He's going to make some expired calls today. Really excited about this. Go back to like you're 12 years old and you want to prank call. You want to prank call the store clerk, the gas station down the road. You want to prank call somebody. That's what this is, man. Have fun with this. Don't care about the outcome. You need to enjoy this, man. This needs to be something you live for. You get the blood flowing, you're feeling good. And if you don't feel like you're on the edge of your seat every second of that, you're not living until you've made some calls or spoke publicly. Do some public speaking. Now, I'll tell you what, it'll put you right on the edge. All right, and that's where you got to be if you want to grow, if you want to really do something special for you and your family. You got to live on the edge. You got to stay on right on the edge of that uncomfortable, those uncomfortable places. Agents come to me, you know, when they're about to be foreclosed on next week and say, what do I do? And you just should have called me months ago, you know, when you started getting these non-payment notices. You want to make some phone calls? Or would you, I guess you would rather go mop floors, roof houses, serve tables, work on an oil rig. I don't know. Making phone calls seems very easy to do over a lot of other things that you're probably headed to if you're not gonna make calls. I don't wanna make cold calls, Ricky. Make warm calls. Call them whatever you wanna call them, man. You know, here's the thing. You have something in common with every single person you call. Every call you make is a warm call. You know why? Because we're all humans living on planet Earth. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're all humans living on planet Earth. That should be in common enough. Like, you're not an animal. You're the same species. You live on planet Earth. We're communicating. All right, let's be friends. Let's be friends.
Let's make this happen, man.
Hello, may I speak to Alex?
Who's
that? This is Chris.
Chris, he's right now, he's still working. You can call us probably at 5 p.m. or after 5.
You said call him around 5 p.m.?
After 5, yeah.
After 5? I'll do 5:15 just to be on the safe side.
After 5.
Okay, no problem.
He has a plan here all the time because he's busy with work.
Got it. And what's your name again? I'm so sorry I missed it.
My name?
Yes.
My name is Nadia.
Nadia. Thank you so much. It's so great to meet you, Nadia. I'll give you a call a little bit after 5.
Yes, after 5.
All right. Appreciate you. Talk to you then. Have a great one.
Okay.
See you.
Who cares? Who cares who you're talking to? Who cares? It's a human being. And people are so worried about people calling back. What is the deal with this, man?
I don't want to say it's the uncertainty, but it's more of, for me, it's more so a reference point, you know? Like, okay, I don't even know what property I'm calling about.
Who cares? So many people, dude, this is one of the biggest, most frequently asked questions. What do I say when, how do you handle when people call you back? Are you kidding me? You answer the phone and say, hey, they're like, hey, you called me. Say, yeah, I was making calls earlier. How you doing today? I'm a local real estate agent. Something I can do to help you? Right? Or yeah, I was calling in a certain subdivision. Do you have a house there? Okay, cool. I sold a house in there last week, or a house sold, or one was listed. Is there anything I can do to help you? I don't understand where the breakdown in this scenario is. I can't wrap my head around this dilemma that people are creating out of thin air for themselves. Let's think about it. Why are we setting ourselves up with a system that we can't scale? Why aren't we putting a system in place that we can scale to the moon very simply? You're complicating the process. You're mixing in phone calls, text messages, postcards, 5x7s, you know, which costs a lot of money, by the way. It costs a lot of money to send somebody a postcard right? Whereas you could have one activity 30 minutes a week and hit your entire database every single week that you can scale to the moon. If you got 50, 500, 5,000 or 5 million people on there, it still only takes you 30 minutes a week. And you ain't got to worry about all these other avenues and 30 touches.
You're right.
You show them how dependable, consistent, hardworking, professional, and honest you are by being a man of your word and sending them an email every single week on the same day of the week forever, right? You're not mixing it up with a bunch of stuff that you can't scale. If you had 3,000 people, you can't afford to send postcards every Monday. You can't. There's no way you can call that many people. Never going to happen. I'm not knocking what you're doing. Anything that you have in place that's gonna build your brand and touch them, I'm all about it. I'm just trying to say, look at it from my perspective. How are we going to scale?
Hey, Brian, it's Chris Newton. How are you, man?
I'm all right. If this is about real estate, we're not selling anything.
Yeah, I know. I see that it came off the market earlier in April.
He hung up?
Yeah.
Because you dropped the ball, bro.
Both it.
You completely blew your opportunity, man. That was your moment, bro. When he says, we're not selling, you say, cool. Is there an agent you would work with if you were to do something?
Mm.
You got to come quick, bro. You gave him so much opportunity to dip.
Mm.
You're just like, oh, yeah, I see that. I see that it was on the market back in April. And, what the? Are you kidding me? Is this a joke? Am I getting punked? Is your wife about to pop out and say, April Fools, this isn't what he really does on live calls?
Oh, man.
Holy smoky dokies.
Hello, Jessica?
Who's calling?
Hey, Jessica, this is Chris Newton, a local real estate agent. How are you?
What?
This is Chris Newton, a local real estate agent. How are you doing today?
I don't know. Who are you?
No, it's okay. You'll get to know me. I'm calling about the house that you have on Roy Street.
Who you want?
I'm looking for Jessica.
Yeah, speaking.
Yeah, Jessica, this is Chris. I'm calling about the house that you have on Roy Street. I saw it came off the market and I wanted the house you have on Royce. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm calling about the house that you have on Roy Street. I saw it came off the market. I want to know if there's anything in the world I can do for you.
Anything what?
Anything in the world I can do for you.
I'll call you later, okay?
You said call back later?
Yeah, I'm busy, okay?
Okay, no problem. What would be a great time to call you? Would 7 work better or would 8 p.m. work better for you?
I will call you back, okay?
Okay, I'll give you a...
Five.
All right, I'll make it easy. I'll give you a call back around 6:30, okay?
What do you mean, 6:30?
Yeah, I'll give you a call back later tonight around 6:30 to give you a little bit more time.
You don't need give me certain time. I will call you back.
Okay. Just consider building your business on a scalable model, right? And what does this do? It puts us in a position where we say on the last call, is it okay if I stay in touch? Cool. What's a good email for you? Just trying to save the world. And please, will you guys click the like button for me on this? Just over here pouring my little heart out for you. I feel like a little tink tink over here. Poor little tink tink.
Poor little tink tink.
Yeah, poor little tinky.